If you need money in GTA 5, be sure to check out cdkeys.com. There's a link in the description where you can find the cheapest shark cards. Hello guys, what's going on? My name is Sam, or Chaotic, and welcome back to another GTA 5 video here on my channel. In today's video, I have some awesome news and information to share with you guys regarding the addition of two brand new vehicles to release next week in GTA Online, alongside some new content as well, on Tuesday, August 14th. Although this information wasn't shared or announced by Rockstar themselves, the official source, it was shared as close as you can get by one of the most trusted and credible sources for leaked information in the GTA community, that being Yan2295. You may recall leaked the entire After Hours nightclub update months ago, so it's believed that Yan has an inside source over at Rockstar Games who is feeding him this information to share early. But he said this on Twitter earlier today. Coming to GTA Online next Tuesday, so Tuesday, August 14th, the Benefactor Terabyte, the Pegassi Oppressor Mark II, new missions, and the final DJ, the Black Madonna. So there we go, although this information hasn't officially been announced and confirmed by Rockstar Games, other than the addition of the Black Madonna, who they already confirmed would be releasing next week, Yan is a very trusted and credible source for leaked information, who is believed to have an inside source over Rockstar Games, who is feeding him this information. And he's been right on just about everything so far. So there we go, in just a few days' time, the Terabyte and the Oppressor Mark II will be released into the game, which I know you guys are very much looking forward to seeing. I myself am very hyped about this, but I'm also very surprised by this information as to why Rockstar are releasing two vehicles next week and not just one, and then holding back the other one to release the following week. Although yes, in order for the Oppressor Mark II to be released, the Terabyte also has to be released, despite being the next vehicle listed on the Warstock Cash and Carry website in the terms of vehicle releases, you have to own the Terabyte and have a vehicle workshop in the back of it if you want to customize and upgrade the Oppressor Mark II. It's only in the Terabyte that can be customized, you can't take it to your MOC or your Avenger and apply the customizations in there. But I just assumed that Rockstar would release the Terabyte first because this vehicle has some of its own features and missions as well assigned to it. These being those new missions which Yan2295 referred to in his tweet. Essentially, in the back of the Terabyte, there will be a PC which you can access, and on this PC, you'll be given a number of different options. Client jobs or resupply missions, such as air freight cargo resupplies, special cargo, vehicle cargo, gunrunning supplies, and biker supplies. The client jobs though being the new missions which will be available with the Terabyte and can only be done or started if you own the Terabyte and then access the PC which they're on. Kind of like the special vehicle missions you can access or start in your MOC. So I just assumed that Rockstar would release the Terabyte on its own, allowing players to enjoy and check out all the features and these new missions, and then release the Oppressor Mark II at a separate time. But this is not the case, and Rockstar releasing both these vehicles at the same time, which is even more awesome. And some information you guys may want to know about these two vehicles before they're released. The Oppressor Mark II can be purchased from the Warstock Cash and Carry website. You haven't got to purchase the original Oppressor, take it into the Terabyte to upgrade it to the Mark II variant. You can just buy the Oppressor Mark II straight up from the Warstock Cash and Carry website, and there are two prices for it. A buy it now price of $3,890,250, or alternatively, there is a trade price for $2,950,000, but you can only unlock this if you own the Terabyte and complete 5 of those client jobs in the Terabyte itself. Now as for the Terabyte, because it's upgradable, prices start from $1,375,000, which isn't too bad, but by the time you start upgrading this vehicle, it can cost upwards of $3.5 million, as you can see in this screenshot, provided by Foxy Snaps. Interiors cost upwards of $100,000, there are interior decals as well you can fit, costing upwards of $125,000. You can also fit a turret to this as well, costing almost $300,000. The Terabyte also has a drone station option, so essentially you can launch drones and control them to go around and kill people or stun people depending on what drones you're using, that costing $800,000. There's also a weapon workshop as well to of course upgrade and customize your weapons, costing $245,000. And then finally, the specialized workshop, so this being where you can customize your vehicles, costing $495,000. so it can get pretty expensive to buy and fully customize a terabyte, but this does have some pretty awesome features, if I do say so myself. Anyway, but there we go. So those two vehicles, alongside the DJ, the Black Madonna, will be available in GTK Online next week on Tuesday, August 14th. That's some pretty awesome news. I hope you guys are excited. I certainly am. I want to hear your thoughts and feelings about this, so go ahead and leave a comment right now. If you guys could also drop a like on this video as well, it helps me out a lot and it's greatly appreciated. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, make sure you do, because I upload all the latest and the greatest Grand Theft Auto 5 content. So as always, guys, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video.